Good afternoon, one and all. So I welcome you all for this session. In general, the session name is Big Data Technology. That means we have to discuss about the technology concept of the big data. What technology actually we follow, we use in order to do big data practically. For that, it is very well known by any people, sir, more people, sir, all people, sir. The Hadoop platform is the number one platform which is used exactly for the use of the big data. How we can be able to find out what are the special features available, what are the more important features available in Hadoop platform. Hadoop is one of the software which act as an intermediary between the big data and the server and the user, which act as a master-slave architecture, like a master-slave architecture. Okay. Now, you know very well, big data is a very popular concept, a popular practical-oriented approach nowadays used. What is the technology growth of the big data? Nowadays, it's not possible to practically analyze all the data available in large volumes because the number of data available in big data concept-based database repositories are very high. So that we require a special kind of softwares to extract all the data available in large volumes. So there are various technology growth nowadays available in order to extract the big data, in order to process the big data, in order to extract the big data. For producing the big data, processing the big data, analyze the big data, the consuming the big data, we require many kind of processes. Okay, so this is the main concept of the big data. Therefore, what are the special informations we require to do the big data? There are various softwares are used in which the number one software nowadays used is Hadoop. Hadoop is mostly cluster-based approach in Hadoop. In Hadoop, the cluster-based approaches are actually carried out. So in the technology growth point of view, data are captured. The technology steps is into help process the data quickly, efficiently, and visualize it. How the informations are actually visualized, how efficiently the technology-oriented this big data are analyzed quickly. These things are discussed. Nowadays, there are various database technologies which are used frequently from faster days. 1990 RDBMS softwares are used. 2001 RDBMS and OLAP, online analytical processing and data warehouse information are processed. After 2015, nowadays we use many kind of platforms which includes NoSQL and database, document-oriented database, Hadoop cluster-oriented database, online analytical processing-oriented, the data warehouse-oriented information. Everything is carried out after 2015. But now for these informations are carried out, processed by using the recent technologies like MongoDB. MongoDB is Cassandra, MongoDB, and other points of processing tools nowadays available in order to access the information. Okay. Now, what is the scenario of using this new era, new technology for the analysis purpose of the big data? For the analysis purpose of the big data, the first layer is the user-oriented recommendation engine. What are the different kinds of document search engines are available? Big data warehouses are available. Big data products are available. Analytics engine, real-time bidding are available. Network optimization technologies, campaign optimization, everything is in the first layer. Now, in the second layer, in the second place, we can have some data access methods. Data access methods are used for what purpose? Means in order to do business efficiently using this business intelligence concept, most of our nowadays the current world utilizing the business intelligence concepts using the data visualization techniques. There are various platforms are available in order to visualize the data which are available anywhere else, which are available in the in most of the servers nowadays. So for example, Amazon server and Flipkart, these are some simple example of visualizing their products by using some special kind of visualization techniques. Okay, so what are the visualization techniques are used for accessing the data, producing the data, showing your data, visualize your data? These things are studied in this place. Okay, then how they are processed by using special softwares, Informatica and Spring Data Oriented, Esper. These are some tools. Some tools are used for processing the data. Pentaho is the intermediary between the visualization and the processing of data. Now, data collection, we use Scribe and Flame. Hadoop based Flame is one of the tool. Special kind of software available in Hadoop is a Flame. Okay, so data processing and data processing methods, data processing tools are utilized to visualize the data which are available in large volumes. Okay, all these informations are stored in a particular place. How they stored? By using Vertica and Infobright, Netezza. These are some tools, these are some softwares used specially utilized for storing the big data. Okay, all this information, Cassandra, MongoDB, Searchbase, everything are actually carried out. And then what is the speciality of this kind of information extraction? First we explain. Now the data mining and the data science, data mining and the data science softwares nowadays are very famous. In older days, SPSS, SAS and Vega, these are all utilized. Now there are various kinds of market software, Karma Sphere for software. These are under the Hadoop platform. Storm, Hatch Streaming, RT. That is, Storm is under the part of RT, and Hatch Streaming is under the part of RT. MapReduce, Hatchbase, HDFS, Cloudera. These are under the Hadoop platform. Okay, for what purpose these tools, these softwares are used? In order to utilize the data mining and the data sciences in information set. Okay, so for the text analysis, various kinds of information are utilized. Text analysis, some other tools are utilized. Finally, for all these things are used for what purpose? Means in order to analyze the availability of big data, the availability of large volume of data. For that, so mostly nowadays the social network analysis is a very famous technology. Now utilized for the analysis purpose of publicly available data. Publicly available data are very large. So in order to utilize this big data concept to analyzing purpose of this social network, we use this big data software. So what are the open source big data tools are available? R, EC2, Hadoop, okay, Stata, Stella, and Hatchbase, and Cassandra, Mahat, MongoDB, Cloudera. These are various Spark, HatoWorks, MySQL, Storm, RStudio, IBM softwares. This is some kind of teams, Google Teams and Google Cloud platforms are utilized for the analysis purpose of the big data. What are the different kinds of tools used in big data? Where processing is hosted? In distributed services, servers and the cloud. In distributed servers and the cloud, the processing is actually hosted. Where data is stored? In distributed storage manner, the data is actually stored. What is the programming model we discussed? Distributed processing model. Especially in the Hadoop platform, MapReduce method utilizes this kind of distributed processing. How data is stored and indexed? The data is stored and indexed by using the high-performance schema-free databases. High-performance schema-free databases. Why we call schema-free? Why we use schema-free databases in big data software, particularly in MongoDB? Means the schema-free databases are actually unstructured databases. The unstructured databases, data or databases are available in very large scale in the various database repositories, various data warehouses nowadays in the field of the railway applications. Okay, therefore, data schema-free databases are mostly utilized in order to get the performance-oriented information extraction. Okay, what operations are performed on data? Analysis, analytic, or semantic processing. Semantic processing is the number one. What is the meaning of available data? What is the use of the data? What it states, what it available, what its applications, what are the usage, ultimate content, everything is analyzed by means of this kind of software. Okay. Now, most popular tool used for the analysis purpose of big data is Cloudera virtual machine. Cloudera virtual machine is the number one tool nowadays used. What are the very famous companies using this Cloudera virtual machines? Nokia software, Nokia company, the Vopower company, and Qualcomm company, Activision. These are some customers of using this Cloudera software. Okay. Now, what popular big data Hadoop tools actually available? Okay, data extraction tools in Hadoop for extracting the data, Tailwind and Pentaho software tools are used. Data storing tool Hive, Scoop, MongoDB are used. Data mining tool is Oracle. Oracle is used to access the data, extracting the data, discovering the data, analyzing the data, okay, by means of writing source code in Oracle. Data analyzing tools are HBase and Big. HBase and Big are used for analyzing purpose of the big data. Then what is data integrating tool? So Zookeeper. Zookeeper is the integrating tool, integrating the data, integrating the database and user, which act as intermediary between the user and data warehouse, is the part of the Zookeeper. Okay. Now, what are the top 10 big data visualization tools nowadays used? There are various tools. Now, frequently we are using Tableau software. Tableau software is very frequently used nowadays in order to visualize the data. Visualize means showing the data. To showing your data, what content available in the data warehouse, how you can visualize the information which are available in large volume of big data concept oriented information repository. All these things are visualized by using this Tableau software. This data visualization using Tableau software is very famous nowadays. Okay, there are various kinds of data are available. Now we discuss about what is Hadoop. It is a framework to process big data. It is a framework to process big data. It is a framework that enables you to store and process large data sets in two ways. One is parallel method and another one is distributed fashion, distributed method. There are two approaches exactly used in Hadoop in order to store and process your data. The data is very large data already stated. Okay. Now, in what method the data are processed in Hadoop? Parallel method and the distributed method. In parallel method and distribution method alone, the data are actually processed. Okay. What are the core components available in Hadoop? There are two core components available. One is HDFS and another one is MapReduce method. HDFS means Hadoop distributed file system. MapReduce, there is no expansion for MapReduce method. By its name itself, you can easily understand what is the use of the MapReduce method. You know that very well about the spanning tree, minimum spanning tree and the tree concept. How we can prune, tree pruning is carried out in the data structures topic. The kind of reducing the number of attributes for the use of the feature applications is the main concept of the MapReduce method. Okay, so there are two components exactly available. One is HDFS and the MapReduce method. Both are work together. Okay, then what is the use of the, what is HDFS and what is MapReduce method? HDFS takes care of storage part of Hadoop architecture. HDFS mostly taking care about how to store the data, in what method, what architecture they used to, for storing the data, everything is carried out. But the MapReduce is a processing model which process the data and which have a software framework for writing applications. The MapReduce method having a software framework in order to write some applications which can run on hardware. Okay. These programs, by means of writing source code, the source code is not directly written by using MapReduce method. You can incorporate writing the source code by using Java language, and then you can incorporate with the MapReduce methods. So that these programs are of MapReduce are capable of processing big data in parallel on large clusters of computational nodes. Okay. There are large number of node are available, computation nodes are available in the big data scenario. So how parallelly all the nodes are extracted, all the nodes are processed, everything is carried out by means of writing a special programs which is used by which is used in MapReduce method. The programs are written by using the any one of your language, either Python language or Java language is available, code and logout language. Okay. What is a Hadoop? It is a Apache Hadoop is an open source software framework. This is used to develop data processing applications with executed in a distributed computing environment. By means of distributed computing environment, this data processing work is carried out by Hadoop. Okay. What are the applications available in Hadoop platform? There are various applications are available. There are various applications are built up by using this Hadoop software, which are run on large data sets across the clusters of commodity of computers. So various clusters of group of computers are utilized for analyzing purpose of this entire platforms. In Hadoop, data resides in a distributed file system, which is called Hadoop Distributed File System, HDFS. Okay. Now, the processing model is based on data locality, where the actual data is captured, actual data is stored, that is data locality. So the processing model must capture the data where the actual data is stored in the database repository. So for that, and the computational logic is sent to cluster nodes containing data. The, by means of some node, the data are actually captured. A compiled version of a program written in high-level language, you can use Java or Python. Java is mostly utilized, such as Java. Such a program process the data stored in Hadoop HDFS file systems. Okay. Then what is the main two sub-projects? Actually, these are some two projects, sub-projects, Hadoop and MapReduce and HDFS are two sub-projects actually available in the Hadoop system, sir. Okay. Now, what is the use of these two systems? Already we discussed about these things. Okay. Now, what is Hadoop ecosystem and the components? The Hadoop ecosystem have Zookeeper, there are various, the MapReduce method, HDFS method. Is the base for this Hadoop oriented ecosystem of components basically. So HDFS is the base, and apart from HDFS, we can extract by using either by using MapReduce method or by using HBase columnar data store. Okay, if you use only the HBase, then directly we can get the benefit from the softwares. Now, suppose if you use MapReduce method, we utilize Hive SQL, R connectors, Mocket, Big, OZ, these things are used. Now, without using this HDFS and the MapReduce, we can use some other kinds of information. For both the purpose of storing, accessing, we can use Scoop, Data Exchange, Flamel, and other things. Zookeeper is also used without all these concepts. Okay, what is the architecture of your Hadoop? Already I informed you, the architecture of Hadoop involves two layers. One is like this architecture, Hadoop architecture act like a master slave architecture. This is master architecture, this is slave architecture. Slave node and master node. In master node, there are two kinds. In the master node, the map reduce layer have two components. One is task taker and job tracker. Task tracker and job tracker are the two components which are exactly utilized in map reduce layer. In HDFS layer, there are two nodes are available, name node and data node. So the name node and the data node is the two components which are exactly utilized in HDFS layer and in master node. Then what is a slave node? Slave node, you know that very well, data node and the task tracker are. Task tracker only are extracted by using this MapReduce, but from the HDFS layer, data node are extracted. Okay, this is the simple concept. And what is master slave architecture? The HDFS source files across many nodes in a cluster. There are a number of clusters, number of nodes are available. Node means computers, node means systems, the node means some kind of processing technique that is called as a cluster. Okay, so therefore, how to follow master slave architecture, and hence HDFS being its core component also follows the same architecture. Okay, name node and data node are the two major components which are exactly utilized in HDFS system. What is name node and what is data node? Okay, the name node maintains and manages data nodes. Okay, the name node keeps the information about the data node. That is the main point. Maintains and manages about data nodes. Records metadata. The name node records metadata. Data about data. Metadata means information about the data blocks. How many blocks are created? Where the location of blocks are actually stored? Location of blocks stored. The size of the files, permissions, and hierarchy, and everything, etc. are carried out by means of this, by the activities of name node, which receives status and block report from all the data nodes. Whatever the data node information, all the data node informations are exactly received by the name node. Okay. Then what is the use of the data node? The data node act like a slave node. It sends signals to name node. Whatever the information processed, the information processed in data node are sent to the name node by means of signals, which stores stores in data blocks. Each and actually data blocks are each and everything is carried out by means of blocks in data node. These blocks informations are stored in the name node. Serves read and write request from the clients. Whatever the information read by the clients and written by the clients, everything is handled by this, stored in data node. Okay. What are the other terms used in Hadoop software? Secondary name node. This is not a pickup name node. Okay. However, it is a This is not a backup name node. The secondary, so sometimes you know very well what about the secondary storage. In secondary storage, if the primary storage is not adequate to store your data, then it go to the secondary storage. But secondary name node will never back up information in this method. It is a separate service that keeps a copy of both the edit logs, the log files, and the file system images. Everything is keeping it in a log file that is maintained, the main work of this information. That is, what is the file system images are, in what format they are stored? FS image is the method of storing the files in this method, okay, in the secondary node, name node. Then what is the metadata? The metadata of name node is managed by two files. One is FS image and another one is edit logs. Already I informed you, edit logs and FS images are created through two kinds of files in the metadata. Okay, what is FS image? This file contains all the modifications that happens across the Hadoop namespace or HDFS when the name node starts. Whenever a name node starts, whenever a processing starts, all the informations are stored in this FS image. Okay, it is stored in the local disk of the name node machine. Whatever the name node machine, actually, in the name node machine, we can use more than one machine for the processing purpose of the Hadoop. Your user machine is a name node machine mostly. Okay. Now, what is the other kinds? Edit logs. What is edit logs? Edit log logs means. This file contains this one of this file method. This file contains the most recent modification. Most recent modification. It is a small file comparatively to the FS image. But FS image having all kind of information about your processing, your data, your storage, your system oriented configuration, everything. So it's stored. It is this edit logs are actually stored in the RAM, random access memory of your name node machine. Your machine is called as actually name node. The data stored, processed and stored in a separate place is called as data node. That is the main point. So secondary name node performs the task of checkpointing. Secondary name node mostly used in order to check the task. Other kind of tasks are used. What is the use of this checkpointing? It is the process of combining edit logs with the FS image. There are two files which is used in this method. One is edit logs and another one is FS image already stated. So the secondary name node creates a copy of log files and FS image from the known node to create a final FS image as shown in the above figure. That is, figure is not given in this. Actually, this edit logs information also stored in the FS images because FS images are keeping all the information about the processing. Okay, so checkpointing is the main concept which are replaced, which happens periodically every 1 hour. The automatic recovery, automatic storage of all the edit logs and final FS image files is created. Why final FS image file is required in secondary node? Suppose you did one processing work 1 hour before, but it is stored in the previous backup file. That is the purpose of using this FS image. So final FS image is the secondary name node allows faster failure. Failure happens. Suppose you don't want to do the current information, so only you want the previous information. So you can get the previous information from the this secondary node, okay, which actually act like that. So new log file in the name node contains all the modifications. In the name node, the new log file contains changes, everything may available in the checkpointing method. It is temporary file. How the data is stored in data nodes using the HDFS data blocks. Each file is stored in HDFS as blocks. The default size of each block is 128 MB. In Apache Hadoop 2.x, 64 MB in Apache Hadoop 1.x. Okay, 128 MB is Apache Hadoop 2.x version 2, 64 MB in version 1. So this is the main method. The block, each and every block is stored. After file is divided into data blocks. Okay, there is a figure available. I am not showing this figure. This data blocks will be then distributed across all the data nodes present in the Hadoop cluster. Then what is the high level Hadoop architecture? Already informed, master slave architecture is used in which name node and the data nodes are used. Okay, what is name node and what is data node, you know very well. Then what is master node and what is slave node, you know very well. Like a master slave flip-flop, this kind of information are extracted. Okay, in Hadoop, master or slave system can be set up in the cloud or on premise. You can set your premise itself, or in the cloud you can set this master slave system. Okay, then what are the special features which are exactly available? What are the special features which are exactly available in Hadoop? Okay, now the special feature, there are various special features available. The Hadoop platform is suitable for big data analysis. As a big data tends to be distributed and unstructured in nature, mostly the big data contains unstructured data. So unstructured data are combined into the organized into the form of a cluster, Hadoop cluster. They are called as Hadoop clusters, which are best suited for analysis of big data. Okay. Now, since it is processing logic, not the actual data, are processed by means of some processing environment. The data are processed by means of some processing environment. Okay. Therefore, this concept is called as data locality concept. Wherever the data is actually available, based on the locality of the data, the informations are processed efficiently and effectively based on these applications of Hadoop-oriented information processing. Okay. What is the other features available in Hadoop? Scalability. Scalability, that is, Hadoop cluster can easily be scaled to many extent by adding additional cluster nodes. This allows for the growth of big data. So scalability means whether this method is fit to analyze all the available data. Yes, it is fit to access all the data, which is fit to analyze all the data, any kind of data, any large volume of data. If any large volume of data is available, this Hadoop system must extract properly, efficiently, effectively. So what is the next concept is fault tolerance. Means the suppose is there any unprocessed data, failure may happen. So whatever the data is not suitable, whatever the data is inconsistent, the inconsistent data are not considered into account. Therefore, the Hadoop system must have some tolerance with the faulty information which are provided in the database oriented information. Okay. Now, what is the main topic about the HDFS? Already, I have explained various information about HDFS. This HDFS is used to store, maintain the very large data. Okay. So, for the purpose of maintaining and accessing, addressing the very large data, this HDFS systems are used. In what method they analyze? They using the distributed file system, in which how many node are available, name node and data nodes are available. What are accessed, the actual data are accessed and stored using the metadata concept. What is HDFS system? What is the architecture of HDFS? HDFS client opens a database by means of distributed file system, read the content of the database, and after reading the content, close the database. This is the HDFS client. Suppose if the database is opened, then the metadata request to be to get a block location where the block is actually available. The name node captures the information. Suppose any metadata flow is not carried out, then automatically this name node is sent to a request to capture once again the information. So this is happened. Then what is FS? Data input stream. Here, another one method is FS data input stream is used in HDFS client based. They also read the information whenever the data node captures some information. The data node captures the information up to the point of capturing the information by means of this data node, all these are extracted. Okay. Now, what are the examples of vendors that provide Hadoop-based solutions? There are various vendors. Already we discussed these things. Amazon Web Services, IBM, Dell, Datamir, Biotel. These are some companies which are exactly utilized the Hadoop-based solutions. Okay, what is the advantages of HDFS and what makes it deal for distributed systems. What makes it a distributed system? Fault tolerance is the advantages of HDFS and systems. So then what it makes to it ideal for distributed systems? So fault tolerant, already I explained what is a fault tolerant. Then the another one point is space. Just add more data nodes. Adding more data nodes is very easy in maintaining the space. So rebalancing the size of the data, rebalancing the size of the space is very easy. Disk space creation is very easily handled in this method. Then the scalability already we discussed. What whether the data or the whether the method, whether the data are exact data are processed or not, whether it is capable of storing the data, whether it is processing large data, the capability of processing the large data, everything. Then another point is flexibility. What is flexibility? Flexibly, it can store any kind of data, any kind of data, whether it is structured data, semi-structured data, unstructured data, all the kinds of data are stored by means of this Hadoop HDFS file system. So cost effective, which have some less cost, but suppose by using the your own storage space, which takes more cost, but the cost effective is very, very less. Okay. Now these are some simple advantages of the Hadoop and map reduce methods. Okay. Now, how we can install the Hadoop commands? This is your practical. Students, you can understand this is your practical. Your practical record. So you have to follow the instructions which are given in your practical. I will send the entire practical record to your mail IDs. Okay, your entire in your mail ID, I will send your records. Okay, all these the total record I will send. How you can read out easily the instructions which are given. Okay, so very simple instructions, just to follow how to install installation of JDK 7. Just in the browser you can download. First you go to download the Cloudera virtual machine, Cloudera VM. You must download Cloudera VM. In the Cloudera VM only these commands are executed, otherwise is no nothing happened. There are other mode, sudo mode. There are two modes are available, sudo mode and other kind of mode. The second mode, the standalone mode. The standalone mode only you can execute. Sudo mode is not suitable for your systems. Okay, so I will send all these commands. What is the use of these commands? Everything is explained in your practical record. You can go through all these informations which are provided in the record itself. I will send to you. Okay, you can try, but it is not possible to try in your home because we require minimum 8 GB RAM in your system. Then only it is possible to activate, do practicals. So only the possibility is come to our college. Therefore, we conclude that what is the use of this Hadoop? Big data is a powerful tool that makes things easy in various fields, as said before. So Hadoop platform is the very important topic which has exactly carried out in order to do practical oriented approaches to get a solution for real life problems using the cloud computing, data mining, finance, marketing, stock, healthcare, etc. So everything is carried out by means of this Hadoop platform. If you have any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we will conclude this session. Thank you for patiently listening of my words. If you have any questions, you can ask now. If you have any questions, you can ask now.